Good? Okay. Hello, everyone. If you're expecting something technical, please leave. This is not. This is going to be just a personal journey over 5 years from knowing nothing about Joomla to knowing the little things I know. First of all, who I am. My name is Noemi Lidner. I'm a graphic designer and coder. I'm a Joomla fan, of course. I love CSS, SVGs, and a full-time geek. That's pretty much who I am. In fact, if you want to find me playing World of Warcraft, you can, every night. Well, what is this? This is what I already told you. 5 years ago, I knew nothing about Joomla. I knew really nothing. And I had to start knowing it. And after 5 years, here I am, trying to know everything. How did it all start? Well, just to put you in place, in Spain, we had a big crisis, this economic crisis. I lost my job, I lost my house, I lost everything over that crisis. And the first time I found a new job after 2 years, it was really a hell of a project because I had to build 278 websites in 9 months using Joomla that I didn't know. Nothing. It was pretty much like this. Everybody was throwing at me those sites and expecting me to do a job actually very, very hard. They were fun. They were about schools and kindergartens, so this is the nice part about those sites. The worst part was the 9 months. I think it's the worst pregnancy I've ever seen. But I was lucky. I had a great team. Me. I was the only one in the team. I had to do everything. I had to code. I had to design. I had to teach the people how to use the sites. It was pretty much a nightmare. I think I spent the first week of the project crying in the bathroom. Then I went out, worked on it, again crying in the bathroom, and trying to sort everything. But then a good thing happened where I live, and it was my first Joomla day, where I met that guy, Roberto, and a few other guys that were talking about exciting things. That day I discovered that Joomla was in fact Mambo, and I did knew Mambo. I was at the very beginning in Mambo. I was a little bit involved in the translation, but I didn't keep following the project. I didn't knew that Mambo was had turned into Joomla. It was nice to know that, and they started to show me modules and extensions, and for someone that had been like 15 years without programming, it was quite a discovery that a thing that I knew when it was born had evolved into a really good tool. And I started working really fast and really hard. So I really managed to get all those 278 sites in time for the project. That was quite cool because I was fired because of that. Yeah, the company wanted to keep dragging money from the government. So because I managed to do it 9 months, I lost my job. It was very, very funny. But it was pretty much the first year. The first year was hard, and I think I'm going too fast. Okay, sorry, really, this is a little bit hard to me. In 2015, I went to the second Joomla Day, where I dared to talk to the guys that were giving the talks. I've never did that. I'm a very shy person, really. I think I'm blushing right now. And I Sorry. And I dare to talk to them because of their talks the previous year. I tried to make something and I did a couple of modules. Really, don't look at the code of those, it's hideous. But these guys were actually excited about them. Really, Roberto took me as a pet. He was like, oh, you did that? And Juanca was pretty much the most excited about this, because in 1 year, I went from nothing to publish 2 modules in the year. It's just, this one today is completely obsolete, because at that point I made the module because I was tired of having a big Google Maps in a site, scrolling down and get caught in the middle of a map. So I made my own to not do that. And then I started to add options to colors and stuff and buttons, and I went crazy, a little bit crazy. Today is not necessary because Google already did that. But at that point, 5 years ago, it was nice. And this is where I started to dig really inside in Joomla and to meet the people from Joomla, to meet the family. So today I think I can call them friends. Correct me. Carlos, please.
We love you, you know it.
He was really good, please.
So I'm someone that finds hard to make friends. And here I found them. That today we talk almost every day over phone and over WhatsApp, and they are my friends. On the next year, again, third Joomla Day. And here it was maybe the more funny thing. Below you can see the name of Pablo Arias. And he was giving a talk there. And I was like, I know this guy. I don't know who he is, but I know this guy. Okay, I went to the talks, I was more involved. I was looking at that point, I was looking for a job because I was completely jobless. I was trying to find someone, but in Spain, with the crisis and being a woman, it's quite hard to find a job in that. And since I've ended my studies, I haven't done anything but that. So I was pretty much, again, at the very same point at the beginning. No job, no money, no nothing, just knowledge. And after that Joomla Day, I found out that I thought that there were only acquaintances, there were friends. In Spain, we use the word friends very lightly. But for me, they are pretty much a little family. My own family is not very big. We are just three people. And these guys, I know that if I need something, I have them. So. You can, please, I need time. Because, yeah, don't worry, really. No, you can answer, why?
Throw it!
Really, my teachers always told me that when I was trying to expose something in class, I was too fast. Even when I was in France, years ago, the French teacher told me that if all her students were as fast as I was, she would be very happy. Okay, a little family. They become family. They help me a lot. They even Carlos gave me a little bit of work. He was my boss for a few days.
No.
Yes.
I was your colleague for a few days.
No, you made me record time. That's false.
No, that's for your own improvement, so you know how much
no,
time you spend
if you
thing.
Didn't make me record the time, I would have charged you more. But
well, you could. I said it free to you.
No. Not really. And fuck. So.
To be honest, I never checked that time, so whatever you have said.
Did you tell me that now? Thank you, Carlos.
I bet
you're not
you're
family.
You're
not
part of the family.
Not the family, the black book. And this happened. The first time I really faced a big meeting, not only in Juna, in everything. Yeah, you can see where the Spanish ghetto in the middle. Because yeah, you are there, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know. So you can look for yourself. I have beer pictures on the presentation. And it was funny because I was jobless. No money, but Juna Project paid for my trip. For my hello, you come and see some. Have a seat, please. Thanks. So I could go. I could go, and there I discovered that my English was not as, it's not good, but it was not that bad. I tried even to keep myself a little bit isolated. Some moments I need to get away from the people, but I couldn't. Every time I went away, someone came, hey, my name is, and who are you? I'm trying to wait. I'm trying to escape. But then I discovered that the little family I had in Spain was way bigger. It had people from all around the world. And people actually wanted to know me and to know what I did, what I want, what I dream. But as I said, I couldn't be alone for just a little second. It was quite a discovery for me because I've been in a lot of Dutch communities over the years. I've been doing this for 20 years now. And I always was an outcast. It's hard sometimes to be the new one and trying to fit. But that doesn't happen in you. Here you can, you come, and everybody is open to you. Everybody, no matter from where, no matter religion, no matter political beliefs, they are here. You are here, all of you. In fact, you are all here, and I didn't want that. So I'm just. And this was right there. Here, it was not only a bigger family, but and I work right now. I'm working Red Web for Ronnie. Most of you know him, know the company. And it was also a great discovery for me because I was used to work for little companies in Spain, where pretty much the team was me, or the only one I've been with where the team was a little bigger, I was the bridge, because as I said, I'm a graphic designer and web developer, so I was the one in charge to translate the language between the two teams. That's pretty much what I like to do, of course. And for the first time, I was working with people from all around the world. We have people, I work with people in Vietnam, I work with people in Denmark, in Guatemala, in Spain, everywhere. I think we have even people here in Germany. I don't know. I'm not sure because we have really too much. And it was really, it was both a discovery, a good thing, and a trap. Because I have my interview via Twitter, yes, via direct message in Twitter. I didn't know Ronnie at the time. And I was hired as a backend developer. I still don't know why, because I'm not. But I
can't do anything.
No, I can't. I've tried and I can't fly. At least which I'll explain. My mom was quite shocked the day I broke my leg. But what? And I was hired as a backend developer. I had to learn a lot because I knew nothing about backend. And the last time I had worked with PHP was when I was 17, that's almost 30 years ago. So yeah, it was hard. And also they made me work with new tools that I didn't know and dig deeper into Joomla Core. I knew a little bit, but not enough. But that made me learn every day and have fun, because it's really funny. It's really, nowadays I can't think about myself working without learning something new each day. It's not really how it works for me anymore. I need to learn. And the good thing about this is not only my coworkers, but all the people I've met in Joomla Days and JM Jones and stuff help me. So I can go on Twitter and in like 5 minutes, somewhere around the world is answering me and is helping me. It's great. And it was, as I said, a little shock to find out that no matter where I was from and what I look like and what I like, that people will want to be part of my group. The next year, I went to Krakow, of course, again. I think I went to every single Joomla event since I started. I tried, at least. And in Krakow, I really had a lot of fun, had a lot of new people, had a lot of friends. So the family is getting bigger and bigger and bigger. Probably most of you have found that, right? Here it is. Can you find yourself?
Yeah.
I think I can say the name of at least half the people that is here. At least. And I know at least half of those people know my name. And this is getting to be part of the long distance family, because I know that some of these guys are also family. Not only the Spanish ghetto is great. But nowadays, thanks to Joomla, I have a work, a job, I have a life, and I have a And that's the year that I also started to be a volunteer in the JAC team. It's hard because I work a lot of hours a day, but I wanted, at this point, I really wanted to get something back to the community that has given me so many things. So work, family, friends, everything. I think today, all my life, both, not completely all, but most of my life revolves around Joomla, with friends and with work. So really, I'm going too fast. That same happened to me the first time I gave this talk. I got nervous and I go fast and fast and fast, so you will have a lot of time to have a drink and a coffee. And oh, perfect, please.
You really want to get to the last slide?
Oh, yes, yes, you will love that.
Do you still have the Joomla extensions in the Joomla directory?
Yes, they are there. They're still there. Look for, wait, Tirabek Studio. Don't look at the code, please.
A two or more than two?
Two. I have two because since I started working thanks to you, I don't have time to do anything else. But I'm doing great things in good way. You know that. We have great projects and it's fun.
You can mention that you are now doing a video called Reviews.
Oh, yes. I will. Don't worry.
Yeah.
Thanks, by the way. I owe you a beer. I would really love to give a little more to the community. And, oh, I forgot to mention one thing. Most of you, how many of you have been involved in Joomla for more than 5 years? Okay. So, you maybe don't realize that, but new people look up to you. I did. I was following you, Chiara, since a long time ago, because I loved your designs. And I was following a lot of more people trying to learn, because as I said, I didn't know anything when I started with Joomla, and I need to know a lot of things in very short time. So I was like lurking everywhere, following everything, going every forum, everything. And for you, for people that's been in the project for a long time, you don't see what you do like it's a big deal. It's what you do, it's what you know. But people like me really follow you and really want to know about what you're doing. And we can even fangirl when we see you in real life the first time. And it's funny because it happened to me at JWC. What you see here, the Joomla Hearthorn logo, is completely done with HTML and CSS. There's no image there. Something I did when I was bored, it took me like half an hour to do so, and I posted it on CodePen. But okay, no one looked at it, it has no many visits, but someone really was shocked about it. And I was in JWC in the dark, chilling out with some friends, and one guy I've been following for a few years came to me and said, "You are Noemi. You are Cybernary." "Yes, I am. Why?" "Because I love your pen." "What? You know that?" "Yes, I love it. I've seen it. It's amazing how you made that." And for me, it was just half an hour because I was completely bored. And because turning certain pictures into maths, into code, is easy and funny. It's what I really love. I love to that mix into maths and art. Because mostly, and this is a great example of that, mostly of them you can turn them into numbers. And numbers can be code. So I was quite shocked to find out that I was being followed, I was being looked up to, and people wanted to know what I did and what I do and what I know. And most of you don't know that, don't really realize that there are a lot of people trying to follow your steps. And sometimes it's hard to follow all of you guys because we want to know. I remember it because I'm still in that phase. I'm still looking up to all the people that is here. For me, it's quite a shock being up here talking to people actually wanting to listen to me. Thank you, Aníbal, I hate you. But I did. Oh, see, this is what happened when you don't know what you're doing. Because you're not used, and my computer is crap.
I heard you're doing great, and you too. Can you please show your passport?
No.
Admin.
Besides,
you saw it. Nice.
Okay. Well, this helped me fill the time. Okay. If I will give you all a link to PayPal so you can buy me a new computer.
Try with Unicode. I think it's Unicode.
No, it's not. Don't worry. You won't find it by reverse engineering or but knowing me because I never use things.
What's the name of your blog?
Zeus.
Thanks.
You want my birthday too?
No. Zeus 2017.
Sure. Yeah, all right. Try it. I've been trying to be hacked a few days ago by a Russian guy. He couldn't. So I don't fear you. And I lost my track completely.
You were talking
about how now we all admire you and follow you.
You can.
Yeah. You're there.
Okay, right. Back to my track. So I will ask you all to try to remember how it was when you started with this. How you felt the first time someone came to you and said, I love what you do. And go to those guys out there that are new, that don't know, and show them that you are people. And you are people I really like. You will find that those looks of joy and surprise and happiness, when it's like when a pop star or rock star you like comes and talk to you. Really, it is. I felt like a rock star last year in JWC when Daniel came to me and said, oh God, you are that. So remember, there are a lot of people looking at all of you like that. There are a few people looking at me like that. And this
when
is...
When this session in La Rioja,
yeah,
it was about coding an extension in 45 minutes.
And I was like...
I did not like it. And you came, and you said, I don't know what you did, but I like it.
Yes.
That's what I said.
I was like a kid, like, oh my God, what this guy is doing. I want to be like him when I grew up.
The rest of people had a lot of people talking to them. Oh, but you were the only one
who
came to talk with me.
Yes, I was. Because it was the most excited thing I started up. The most exciting thing I've seen that day. Really, I love code, and he was like, this is no big deal, I'm making this. Okay, so where am I going? I want to collaborate a little more with the project, otherwise he's going to kill me. But sometimes life mess up with what you want. So I want to make Joomla more accessible. Yeah. Because one of the things I had to do in that hell of a project was make sites accessible for, because it was for schools and sometimes it was for specialist schools. And I think the way Joomla is taking over there is a great one, because there is nothing like that. So I want to really step in it to really help. Basically, I want to give back what Joomla has given to me. A family, a way of life, because this is what Joomla is. It's the heart inside the community. And I'm sorry I went too fast, but we can talk a lot. And wait for it, because this is what really Carlos wants you to see. I swear, he made me do it.
Wait.
Oh, yeah. And what is the hashtag? Spam is sexy.
Okay, spam is sexy. Wait, no, it's not going anywhere. Is it what the picture? I can.
Who you stand?
He said, I won't dare to do this here.
Listen, you want a Mac the first time you did it.
Yeah, but that was in at home. So
can I give him a photo already?
Okay, we have a lot of time for questions. Like a lot of time.
Is that a question? Can I ask you?
Yeah, sure.
The general love that you did that is like painting and all that. How can I get it?
Oh, it's in CodePen. I will give you the link.
Can I use it for a presentation?
Of course. Of course you can.
Copyright?
No, it's
can use it just
it's open source. You can use it and it's quite actually it's quite easy to. It's not the best, I have to say it's not the best code because it was fast and it's really, you can modify it and make it responsible, for instance, it's not. And there are a few, if you look here, there are a few lines where it overlaps and I don't like it. But it's hard when you turn things with 3D transformation to make everything crispy. When you're working with that many elements. If they are upwards, they look great. When you turn them, it's just a little bit of a mess.
But you can use it.
Yes, of course, completely.
Because it's live, someone else can use it if they wanted to. Difficult, completely. And in fact, the platform called Pen, it's
for this kind of stuff. You have all the code, HTML, CSS, JS, and the view, and you can fork and work and do whatever you want.
But how can I make the use of it? Like for example, you know Canva? Canva.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Create presentations for that, and mm-hmm. How can I use it with Canva? Is it possible?
Well,
I'm not sure
it should be.
Much time
can you support it something else, like a GIF? Maybe?
Yeah, that's what I'm asking.
Mm.
Oh, no, I don't have it. Don't laugh at this. Please. Yeah, in fact, here it is.
So this is
this is the code.
Okay.
Code here.
The HTML.
Yeah, wow.
It's quite easy. So basically, you have to take this code. And my stuff, CSS, and delay, and Joomla Heart. Here are the CSS that turns everything. As you see, I try to use names quite easy, like top circle, top arch, inner arcs, whatever. It's quite, you can, I will give you the link in CodePen. As you can see, it's really nothing special, nothing hard.
Yeah, you can probably just record it, probably like if you want it as a GIF, record it as a video.
Hmm. Yes, you can.
Record it as a GIF. That's what you mean.
See, if you're working in Windows for GIFs, I use LiseCap. And but if you want to use in code, you can use the code and.
I will work for the presentation because I do a lot of presentation and I really liked it, so
okay.
If GIF, then it's
GIF is easier, yeah.
Yeah, GIF is easier.
Yeah. I think that we have that in some repository for Joomla. So if you'd like to use it as a GIF,
The funny part about this is the fact that it's code.
Yeah.
Yes, but probably Kiara has a better
image. Yeah, if you have an image, you do it with the image.
Yeah, with images, it would look crispier and better.
If I'm sure we did that in GIF, could you give me your image and send it to you?
In fact, I think I saw that GIF, and that's why I did the code.
Yeah. When the story behind this is with Sarah, because Sarah, so we were talking about having the heart for the community. So we created the banners of different things, and I'm sure we have a GIF animated where the his heart is pulsing like she did.
Yeah,
I
just
put that on my site.
Yeah, so you can find that. I can send it to you. I'm sure I have it. We have a pen I can give it to you. I mean, I can give it to you right now. I have it with me. Yeah, another time. So, I mean, just find me in 3 days. But that's not because you can use a whole website, just call them, just work, just embed it.
It's the fun thing.
Yeah, no. But I remember that there was a guy, I don't remember now, it was Brian, and he created the Joomla loading image.
Sí. Yes.
So that was also, these are little things that's nice to do, and someone would find it useful to have it. Like you say, I want to use somewhere in my presentation on the website. So it's not, it's fun for you, but for someone it's like, oh, this is cool, I'm going to use it.
Yeah.
So it's great.
Yes, also we can see the dots in your row when you started. You started creating 200 sites and doing everything.
Yep.
But today, after so many steps, you are doing code reviews.
Yep.
Helping others to improve the quality of code.
Yep.
And that's amazing. In 5 years from, do everything and just a bunch of sites, and I'm growing until it's
possible. And I swear those sites, today I look at them and I don't want to say I did them. Really.
That's part of the joke.
Yeah, as I said, as Hannibal said, today I'm doing code review in Red Web, and it's fun when you have the power to say no, you shall not pass.
We don't make websites anymore.
Yes, I do. I do both things. I work on the sites. I'm still the bridge between the developers and the designers because I speak both languages. I'm not great at neither of them because I can't focus just in one, but I understand what the designer says and what the developer says, and I can make them understand each other. Yeah. And
you're
the bridge.
Middleman.
Yes. As I like to say, I'm the unicorn.
Yes, yes.
I still, in fact, I have it in my arm, and that's what I'm doing right now. Coding. Mostly backend and reviewing. Yeah.
Nice. And Ronnie, so now you're working with Ronnie and that work.
Yeah, it's been
it's
2 years.
Team, yeah?
Yeah, it's a big team, it's a big deal for me because as I said, I was used to working very small companies with all the people in one room.
In Spanish.
Yeah.
And in Spanish, everything in Spanish.
Yeah.
Sometimes in Galician. Because I'm from a place where we already speak two languages.
Yeah, and you're back. Okay, nice. But it's nice because so that means you can meet other people from other.
Yeah, and I've been offered a home in several countries already.
Yeah.
That's great for vacation.
Yeah. So it's nice.
Yeah, it's very nice. We still have time. I'm fast. I'm always fast with this kind of stuff.
No, but it's okay. I mean, you say what you want to say, and it's clear, and it's amazing how Joomla changed your life.
Completely. I have to say my life is not nearly the same that it was before Joomla.
Yeah, definitely. But I think everyone here can say the same. I mean,
in fact, Joomla really saved my life because I was in a point where I was homeless. When I found that hell of a project. And I think I was the one who took it because no one dared to do that because probably no one that applied to the job really needed that as I did. It was that or living in the street. So I can say Joomla saved my life.
Thank you.